lives in northern Arizona knows spring as the windy season.
So let's take a few minutes to talk about why it's so windy and the science behind it.
There are a couple of reasons behind the springtime wind, the first being that spring is a transition season when the jet stream is moving from a more southern location to a more northern location. During this transition, we often get very strong and cold low-pressure systems diving into the southwestern United States, and this is the main forcing mechanism behind the winds. So the classic weather pattern setup that we look for with these events is a deep low-pressure trough approaching Arizona from the west or the northwest. Usually these are associated with a strong and potent cold front. We look for the winds to develop in the very dry prefrontal southwest flow ahead of the main front. As the low approaches the state, pressure gradients strengthen across the area and cause the strong winds to develop. The second reason behind the strong spring wind is the fact that we have much more solar heating from the sun. This allows for more turbulent mixing in the atmosphere as air is heated and rises up from the ground. This deeper layer of mixed air then allows stronger winds aloft to reach the ground surface.
So why are some spots so windy? Well, let's start with an example. Here, for instance, we have Mount Eldon, a 9,300-foot mountain barrier on the east side of Flagstaff. During the cooler months of October through May, oftentimes, a layer of stable, descending air is found in the mid-altitudes. When a strong west or southwest wind blows, it is forced to rise up and over the mountain ridge and into this layer of stable air. Sometimes, a broad wave cloud can be seen above the mountain peak as some of the wind's momentum is deflected vertically into this stable layer. On days with very strong winds, this type of cloud feature is very common. We call this a mountain wave. Closer to the ground, as the air blows back down the mountain slope, it becomes enhanced due to the effects of the mountain wave, with the winds increasing by the downward deflection of energy by the stable air. It may also be enhanced by local channeling through valleys and canyons, further increasing the wind speeds. Locations downwind of these mountain peaks, such as Dhoni Park in this case, can then experience winds many magnitudes greater than observed on the upwind side of the peak. There are numerous hotspots which favor high winds across northern Arizona. Localized areas of strong winds are common downwind of the Kaibab Plateau and in the Dhoni Park area, while more broad-scale strong winds are found in the Little Colorado River Valley as well as the Black Mesa and Chinle Valley areas. All of these locations are downwind of large mountain barriers, with winds becoming stronger as they blow downslope through these regions. Additionally, in the Black Mesa, Chinle Valley, and Little Colorado River Valley regions, the terrain is largely flat or gently sloping, with little vegetation, resulting in minimal frictional drag to slow the winds down.
One of the biggest impacts we see here in northern Arizona from these strong wind events are when they generate large areas of blowing dust. These are different than the typical monsoon season dust storms, which are generated from thunderstorm outflow winds. These springtime dust storms are driven by large-scale wind events that are not necessarily associated with thunderstorms at all. The areas that most commonly receive these dust storms are portions of northeastern Arizona, north of Flagstaff in the Mogollon Rim extending to the Four Corners region. This is generally an area that receives less precipitation and therefore has less vegetation. During extended dry periods, there's often dry, loose soil available to be lofted into the atmosphere. In the past few years, there have been a few notable events where frequent wind gusts near 60 miles per hour caused large dust plumes to extend across the entire northeastern portion of the state. A couple of these events have been captured on visible satellite imagery, one from 2009 and another very recent event from April of this year. The blowing dust can easily reduce visibility and cause difficulty for travelers. Visibility can frequently drop below a quarter of a mile and sometimes can drop to near zero. The more significant events in the last few years have caused extended road closures, including Interstate 40, that have lasted up to several hours and caused significant travel delays.
Wind also plays a significant role in fire danger and fire behavior. Persistent strong winds can quickly dry out grasses, shrubs, and other fine fuels, which can rapidly raise the fire danger. Upon fire start, strong winds also work to fan flames and ventilate a fire, which can lead to rapid or even explosive growth and unpredictable fire behavior. This can cause fires to grow out of control and quickly become difficult to manage. Strong winds can also transport embers downwind, sparking new fires. This is a process called spotting and can make a bad fire situation even worse.
So when will the winds finally relax? Usually April and May feature the strongest winds as strong storm systems transit the western states and a deep boundary layer allows strong winds aloft to be transported to the surface. As we progress into June and July, however, the jet stream lifts north towards the Canadian border, allowing the strong winds to relax.
As this happens, high pressure builds across northern Mexico and the southwest, with the monsoonal flow usually taking shape in July. This allows moisture to pump into the region with frequent shower and thunderstorm activity, and much lighter winds for the remainder of the summer.